Hi, my name is Jacob Wiegand, and welcome to my biology project.
Then we're going to get our turn to see
All
him.
right, so here I am in the Atlanta Zoo for my school project. This here is the Himalayan red panda.
Hey.
All right, so the Himalayan red panda is native to Southeast Asia. And although it shares the name, it has little similarities with other panda species. They are incredibly endangered because of habitat destruction and many other factors.
Then we're going to get our turn to see him.
All right, now we're going to talk about the binomial nomenclature, and that is the Loreus fugens. And the genus Loreus has only one species, which is the red panda. In fact, the entire family of Aloridae has only one organism, which is the red panda. All the others are now extinct. Despite sharing the same name, the red panda shares very little with the more well-known giant pandas. They're likely very distant cousins, very distant, and the only thing they really have in common, other than the name, is they both have a diet of bamboo leaves. As you can see, they both share the same order, but they are from very different families, and they are very distantly related from one another. Red pandas share more traits with raccoons than pandas. In fact, they were initially classified as raccoons. They share traits such as similar physical appearance, fur patterns, and general body shape and this here is the earliest ancestor to the red panda, which has a genus and species I am not going to attempt to pronounce. Though they are much earlier than the red pandas we have today, they are still not related to the giant pandas all that much. The tongue twister of a genus actually means former or previous, which in turn means that this is essentially the previous red panda. Bamboo used to grow in many more places, such as Europe and Tennessee. However, the Ice Age destroyed many of the world's bamboo supplies, leaving it only in Southeast Asia, where the red panda is now plentiful. This is the cladogram of the red panda that shows how it is somewhat related to the red panda. Feel free to pause here if you want to take a look. The modern red panda has a stronger jaw because of the crest bone in its skull. However, the ancestor was taller, longer, and had a longer snout. The red panda has developed a sixth thumb that allows it to tightly grip its main food source, bamboo. So here you can see in these pictures how a human hand, which has five fingers, a much longer thumb, and the panda hand, which has six fingers and a very tiny, short, almost stubby false thumb. Fun fact, the internet browser Firefox is named after the red panda. A firefox is a nickname for a red panda. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the presentation and learned something new. Also, Ms. Washington, I know you're watching this sometime in the future. Please be very gracious with my grade.